Estamos con el Dash Jet Team y con el capitán Scott Farnsworth, que es piloto de este Albatros L-39, right?
What we have behind us is a Super 39. It starts out as a Czechoslovakian-born L-39, and then through technology of titanium and carbon fiber, we've made it into a Super Albatross, where it's about 25% less weight at 20% more thrust, and we're running about 100 knots, which is about 120 miles per hour faster than a stock jet. We race this aircraft at 550 miles an hour at 50 feet in a pack of 8 other jets. I'm trying to become the fastest race pilot on the planet. I believe this aircraft and the support of Method 7 eyewear, with their support, we're going to be able to achieve this goal this year.
Lo que nos está platicando aquí el capitán Scott, bueno, Dash, el Dash Aerosport hacen carreras de aviación, you do air racing y también hacen acrobacia, aerobatics. Y nos está contando que este es un L-39 Super Albatros porque está modificado, como nos comenta, tiene una reducción de 20% de peso porque tiene partes de fibra de carbón y 20% más potencia porque le modificaron el motor que tiene acá atrás. Y ahorita van a ver un poco el motor y de las modificaciones y de la aviónica, y Scott nos comenta que están más o menos alcanzando una velocidad de 550 millas por hora. Es una velocidad increíble, y les voy a poner el link a su video de las Reno Air Races, donde está volando a 50 pies sobre la tierra a estas increíbles y muy altas velocidades.
I'm a professional airline captain that I fly an Airbus 320, 321 for a major airline. I do that from Monday through Friday. And when I'm not flying an Airbus, I'm out flying my, I have an Extreme Air Unlimited Aerobatic airplane, as well as I have two of these jets. And I'm always practicing air show aerobatics, different maneuvers, formation training.
And tell us a little bit, why the Albatross? Why is it so versatile? What does it have that other fighter jets of the time didn't have, and why is it so good for racing and for
this is
aerobatics?
A great question. Absolutely wonderful question. So the Albatross, I've flown pretty much all the different classic jets. Obviously F-16, F-18, these are amazing aircraft, but a lot of us don't have the budget of the U.S. military of, you know, $20 million and so forth. The different Czechoslovakian-built airplanes, I like to call them the AK-47 of the sky. For other airplanes, if you fly an hour, you need to have about 18 hours of maintenance. I've flown this aircraft 26 hours, racing, air shows, cross country, and then dropped it off with my crew chief. He's topped off the fluids, changed out the tires, and we were ready to rock and roll. So the maintenance costs of these aircraft are amazing. Now, what you actually were asking is why so much the Albatross? For our air racing, it's like Formula One. We have to have what's called a straight wing without a sweep to it and no afterburner. And the Albatross has proven to be pretty much the top pinnacle for the sleek aerodynamics of a straight wing, no afterburner, to allow us to reach the top speeds allowed on the racetrack arena. And then anybody that's flown any of the Yaks or the Czechoslovakian aircraft with the flight systems, they're just second to none on that sweet pilot feel that as you're doing your aerobatics and your maneuvers, you just have complete control, smooth controls. It's just a joy to fly. So like I was saying, we started out what we like to call Czechoslovakian born, American made. Starts out as a 1984 Czechoslovakian L-39. The skin and the ribs are still in the same place, but everything else has been replaced. Absolutely everything. All the wiring, original wiring's gone. Where our engine, the Czechoslovakian engine, has been taken out. We have a what's called a Garrett 731, comes from a Learjet. It's got a digital computer control system, and it puts out 3,800 pounds in normal, and then I have a little bit of tweaks that I'm able to do for the racing. Our total weight is 5,900 pounds. Stock is about 7,600 pounds. So, like I said, we're about 2,500 pounds lighter. Please follow me around the aircraft. All custom, everything from the tail back, we've handmade all of our components. Hand components. So inside this belly here, normally there's a lot of 1968, 1975. Perfect, F-15 going full afterburner on takeoff, love it. So normally this fuselage is pretty stuffed with equipment and components that are required to make that technology work. But because of the new technologies that we have, this is almost empty. It's literally, I'd say about half full. I can stand up inside the engine bay of this aircraft. And that's just an example of how light we are. The aircraft does not have an engine-driven hydraulic pump anymore. It's all electric, solid-state electronic control unit. So we can actually operate all of our components on the jet while sitting on the ramp and the engine is off. That's completely unusual, but it makes it great for our reliability on the road as well as troubleshooting. As you can see, we've taken off the normal standard tip tanks. We've got this beautiful carbon fiber. We just cap it off as we start up the engine. You can hear that right there. We have a battery start and the computer starts the engine for us, fires it up. We've got light off. At this point, the computer's basically taking care of everything. It's the latest in technology as far as a classic warbird jet. We're really excited. Another example is spool up time on a jet engine for an L-39 is usually 12 seconds. This is 2.
Ya vimos el Albatros L39, Super Albatros modificado. Ahora Scott nos va a platicar un poco de un L39 original, stock, no modificado, que es este que tenemos atrás.
So Scott, tell us a little bit about the differences between your Super Albatros and the stock Albatros.
Yeah, so what we were just showing you is the Super Albatros that comes in right about 5,900 pounds empty. Right here we have a beautiful example. Steve, I fly with quite a bit in formation. Steve has a beautiful example of what we call a stock L-39, really a warbird classic here. He even has the live Sidewinder missiles underneath the wing. We're obviously built for low-level pylon racing as well as maximum performance for the aerobatic box. So this is a beautiful example of a classic L-39 that's true warbird setup. All the way to the custom-built Sidewinder missiles here. Steve has a great time with this. His pitot tube is set up so it looks like a 50 cal. Mm-hmm. But also you can see that he carries about 26.8 gallons on the wings. So all of this stuff is really great and it looks wonderful. And the jet is a great example, but it all adds weight. And we all know if you've ever seen a Ferrari or a Lamborghini, it's all about taking the weight out and putting as much horsepower back in. And that's really what Dash Aerosports is all about. I'm absolutely maximizing the absolute best performance for our aircraft.
Miren amigos, aquí nada más para que vean un poco para dos personas. Do you mind if I show the avionics real quick?
Put a hand there and a right foot or left foot. There you go.
Okay. Miren amigos, esta es la aviónica. You got a G3X, right? Entonces ya tienen aviónica más moderna, como pueden ver tiene un G3X, pueden ver el joystick, tiene hasta un iPad y acá atrás va el segundo piloto al mando y acá estamos. Thank you. Bueno amigos, pues muchísimas gracias. Scott, thank you very much for letting us see your modified Albatros and talking a little bit about the original Albatros and what you guys are doing. Amigos, también muchísimas gracias a Method 7, los lentes que nos hicieron posible hacer esta entrevista con Scott, patrocina el equipo de Scott. Les voy a dejar un link al YouTube de Scott para que puedan ver las Reno Air Races desde la cabina de Scott. Y well, Scott, thank you.
And you can find us on Instagram or Facebook under Dash Aerosports. I'm going to go ahead and give you a video that we just shot yesterday where we were in formation with this L39. We both went, he went all in first, I waited a little bit, then we went forward, and you can just watch us launch off. So I'll give you that video and hopefully you can include that in the content.
Of course, y bueno amigos, pues muchas gracias. Scott, once again,
thank you
very much, and all our fans in Mexico will be very thankful to see these fighter jets.
And we hope to see you at one of our air shows in the in Mexico or in Central America throughout 2019.
Pues amigos, muchas gracias y nos vemos hasta la próxima.